In class 7, physics, we will start with the speed of sound. You already studied that sound can travel through solid, liquid and gases, that is medium should be there, with defined speed. Sound travels with the slowest through gases, fast through liquid and fastest through the solid. This is because of the solid distance between the molecule is very small, as the solid is denser in comparison to liquid and gases. Hence, it is easier to for the molecule in solid to transmit the vibration to the adjacent molecule. In gaseous molecule, the further apart, so it is not easy for the vibration to travel. So in here, the speed of sound on, depends on many factors, that is temperature, humidity, air and the strength of the wind. So example, if we see the speed of sound in air increases with the increase of the temperature. The speed of sound is about 343 meter per second at 20 degrees centigrade. At the speed of light is about 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So if we see when firework explode, we saw a big burst of color before you hear the noise. The lightning flashes across the sky before you hear the thunder. So this is the speed of sound. Now move on to the reflection of sound. When the sound wave fall on the surface, there is a bounce back from the surface, and the phenomenon is known as reflection of sound. And this wave that travels towards the reflective sound is called incident sound ray. And the sound wave that bounces back from the relative reflective surface, that is called reflective sound. So here a phenomenon of sound utilized working on the devices like loudspeaker, soundboards and hearing aids. Now move on to the echo. Echo is the Greek word which means sound, and echo occurs when hills wall of the building reflect sound. And echo is the repetition of sound produced when a rigid surface reflect the sound. When we shout a big room such as auditorium or in an open space surrounded with a mountain, we hear multiple echoes. This happens because of the sound is reflect from wall to another, and that is called another. That is the collection of reflected sound is called the reverberation. So echo and reverberation more or less same kind of thing. In case of what is the minimum distance required for the hear of an echo? That is why if we see the ear, a small space, crowded space, we do not hear echo. Why? There is definitely reflection of sound in small room, but we are not able to interpret an echo in a small room because the human ear brain can distinguish two distinct sound only the gap between 1/10 of that particular second. So therefore we can hear the echo of sound, only the reflected sound reaches our ear 1/10 of the second, that is in small room it is not happened. So due to this, this 1/10 of second, since during the time our brain still the first sound here stored, recognize the second sound, we cannot hear an echo. The speed of sound approximately 340 meter per second. The reflective surface, if we see the distance, then 340 meter per second equal to 2d by t. Then if we see the 2d, then 2d equal to 34, then 17 meter, at least 17 meter from the resource of sound, that is actually for the echo. In case of sonar, there is navigation and ranging in the technique that is based on the principle of reflection of sound to detect the locate underground object, depth of the water of bodies. When ultrasonic wave are transmitted through water, they are reflected back to the source of sound, the strike on object. The location of the object, of the distance of the underneath object from the source, can be measured by calculating the time it takes for the sound wave to return to the source. So application of sonar, if we see, to identify a submarine from the surface of sea, to measure the depth of the ocean, to find large shoal of fish deep under the water, to navigate the sea. So today up to that, next we will start with another.